you know, we have this whole criminal justice system that is based on that system of thought, that way of thinking about human beings are bad and they need to be punished and we need to put them in a cage, and that's how we deal with this problem. And as you pointed out, you know, it's just scientifically inaccurate to say that these people choose to do this, that people choose to become these drug addicted, whatever they do to get there. And I think that the psychedelic research that is being done is a part of this new story that's showing that no, in fact, that is not why this is the case. That is not why this is happening. We need a more empathetic and more empathetic understanding of how people get into the situation. And I think that ultimately that new way of approaching this subject, and it's not even necessarily new, but it's a new way of it that it's coming about, that it's kind of an affront to the way the whole criminal justice system works. So as this research starts to come out and as you do more and more of your research, I think it's going to further undermine the legitimacy of the claims that are being made by people like, you know, here in the United States, we have our Attorney General Jeff Sessions, who wants to kind of sort of start the drug war over again and go back to the good old days when people would, you know, throw just this sort of nostalgic view of how the criminal justice should be done. And so I think that psychedelic research is actually a gateway in some way to an understanding of how the brain actually works, how the brain actually develops, and that in turn can kind of generate more empathy and more understanding, which is so important and so necessary.
Yeah, because it's false economy to do anything else. You know, if locking people up worked, or if prohibiting drugs worked, then, you know, do it. Let's do it. That's great. Let's improve society in that way. But it just doesn't work. And it's extremely expensive. And not as well as being morally and ethically wrong. So if we don't look after people who've been through these negative experiences and we don't nurture them and we don't help them back on their feet, we can lock up as many millions of them as we want. They ain't going to go away. In fact, we're going to just further traumatize them. And as I said, not only is that morally and ethically wrong, but it's extremely expensive. You know, there's nothing more expensive than a one-legged HIV-infected, hepatitis-infected heroin addict who's homeless. They cost the state millions. So we need to care for these people, and simply locking them up doesn't make them go away. It just perpetuates the problem. So we need to put money into the professions that can turn these things around. We can't arrest our way out of this problem.